Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Friday, December 4th, 2009. In the pre-market this morning, with 2 hours to go before the market opens, we've got futures up slightly. European markets are down at the moment. We've got U.S. employment numbers coming out at 8:30. Canadian employment numbers came out at 7 a.m. They were quite positive, so we should expect positive numbers at 8:30. Positive numbers do not necessarily equate to higher stock prices, so just be aware of that. Now, Thursday's market activity looks like it could mark the top for this market move to the upside. Last three bearish reversal days that we had on the S&P 500 marked the ends of the runs for those particular moves. We had one yesterday. We had some bearish reversal signals on Wednesday that we were watching. We saw fall through to the downside for those signals. And so we're looking to see if we get lower prices on Friday, which should help confirm the bearish reversal signal here that you see in the S&P 500. And we saw that in a lot of stocks and indexes on Thursday. Now, we're still looking for a breakout of last Thursday's low. So while we can see a breakout of some recent prices, we can get a new sell signal. We're really looking for a breakout below 1,086.25, a breakdown, excuse me, to the downside to tell us that we are trading out of this range. Currently, we're still in the range, so we haven't made any new ground. It looks like we, you know, tried to break out to the upside, failed, got a bearish reversal day. Now we're back in the channel. That doesn't matter that much. What matters is if we break out or break down below 1086.25. Taking a look at the VIX came down, filled the gap, and reversed sharply yesterday. So we were looking to see if the recent lows, two lows, would hold. So far they have. We filled the gap and reversed sharply. Again, you know, this is what you look for to see, you know, as a setup for a major trend change, bearish reversal signals or bullish reversal signals at the bottom. And certainly to fill a gap and reverse sharply from that gap is certainly something that we need to watch closely. Now, looking at my five favorite stocks, for Apple Computer, it was down on Thursday. We need a daily close above 204. For the CME Group, while we were watching that bearish reversal signal, we need a daily close below 322. For Google, we need a daily close below 578 to give us a sell signal on Friday. Goldman Sachs was down sharply on Thursday. We need a daily close above 172 to give us a buy signal right now. For Research in Motion, no go on Thursday. We need a daily close above 6050. Yesterday, we were watching MasterCard. It gave a bearish reversal signal on Wednesday. We certainly had fall through to the downside on Thursday. Nice big red bar. Came down to the lower channel line, didn't break through it. We need a daily close below 235 on Friday to give us a new sell signal. Taking a look at Visa, Visa also showed up yesterday as a bearish reversal signal from Wednesday's close. A sharp down day on Thursday, early warning signal. A close below 79.90 would give us a new daily sell signal on Friday. And another credit card stock that was down sharply on Thursday, American Express. Now, we also looked at Gammon Resources, which gave us a bearish reversal signal on Wednesday. That was down again on Thursday, not enough to give us a sell signal. A daily close below 1110 would give us a sell signal on Friday. And another gold stock that gave a bearish reversal signal on Wednesday, IM Gold. It was down again on Thursday. A daily close below 1875 would give us a new sell signal on Friday. Now, taking a look at the daily charts, we don't have to look at all of them this morning. Bank stocks in general, not credit card stocks, but bank stocks were flat on Thursday. Sharp move down in bonds, and of course we saw the VIX reverse off the open gap. So while the VIX was going up, bonds were dropping, so we're now on a sell signal for the 30-year bond. So we need to abandon that position and go short on Friday. Looking at the S&P 500, a daily close below 1085 would give us a new sell signal right now, but it's really that move below 1086.25 that we're watching for. Taking a look at the NASDAQ on Friday, we need a daily close below 1772 to give us a new sell signal on Friday. Again, we were not able to break out of the range to the upside. And looking at bank stocks on Friday, they were flat on Thursday, believe it or not, even though with the downward pressure in credit card stocks. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. Have a great day. Should be exciting to see what happens after those employment numbers come out. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.